Oh, hi. I was just writing my book. Guys, some of you may be wondering what happened to the biggest problem in the universe. There have been a lot of lies and rumors and gossip told about it, so I may as well go ahead and tell you guys exactly what happened. The podcast didn't end because of creative differences. This is a conversation Dick was having behind my back. The same guy who came into my house year after year pretending to be my friend, in his own words, said that he was only doing the podcast for fans and for money. After the podcast ended, he said that I deleted the website. Not true. I created most of the content on the website. Why the fuck would I delete it? Dick's job was to maintain WordPress, and there were dozens of plugins that weren't being updated. He was negligent, so I converted the old site to static HTML, which is faster and more secure. I even paid for it myself out of my pocket. The old RSS feed costs money, guys, and can't stay up forever, so I uploaded all the files to SoundCloud so you can listen to them indefinitely. You're welcome. He said he emailed me about this, and I didn't respond.
So I fire off an email to Maddox. Hey, man, I got a big problem with this. Here's the feed link. So I get no response to that.
Huh. That's weird, because I definitely responded.
So I get no response to that.
Dick's been withholding financial records from me for quite some time, so I responded to him and asked him to send me those records. His refusal to send me these forms is suspicious, especially considering the fact that I found discrepancies in his accounting in the past. Then he started lying about things he didn't even need to lie about. He started telling people he didn't know anything about my new network. Huh, my bad. I guess I should have sent him something like an email on April 5th, going into detail with a bullet-pointed list and a strategy. Oh wait, I did. Then I found out that he was telling fans, without my knowledge, that it was okay to steal the bonus episodes. So I uploaded them all for free. Guys, we definitely had creative differences on the show, but it's misleading to say that I forbade the Titanic bit. That was one of my favorite bits on the show. I simply asked him not to tie it to the weekly voting because it would lead to a large number of fake votes in the database, and that's exactly what happened. So I asked him to find another way to do the bit on the show. In fact, I even sent him an email last December suggesting he bring the bit back. So to wrap this up, there are definitely two sides to every creative difference, but there aren't two sides to this. He lied about the reason the podcast ended. He lied about me deleting the website. He lied about the financial forms. He lied about the network. He lied about the bonus episodes. He lied about the Titanic bit. And he's unprofessional and he talks behind people's backs. People have asked me if there's any chance of reconciliation. Absolutely not. I don't deal with baby dick. Guys, it sucks that the podcast ended, but it's time to move on. I've already started an awesome new podcast and most people love it. Some people don't, and that's okay. You're allowed to have bad taste. Oh, and one other thing. He used to complain about me editing the episodes. The reason I edited them is because he would say things that were incompatible with my values.
Really upsets me that responsibility isn't put on her. We're telling people this.
I do want to add something just to the last point you made, which is they said that we should stop telling women that it's their responsibility to protect themselves.
It is.
Well, to an extent, yes.
100% it is.
No, Dick, it's not.
Dude,
you're
yes,
a fucking
it is.
Bullshit. No. If you pass out drunk in a party or whatever, you shouldn't expect to get raped.
Yes, you fucking should.
Oh, dude, big foul. No, you can't say that's fucking bullshit. That's absolutely bullshit.
And in case you don't think this is serious, his show's own message board maintains a rape list.